Bam! Mr. Taru, let me first by thanking the 111,000 subscribers I have so far on my channel. Thank you for choosing my channel for learning math from using my free lessons. The second thing is, you will notice as you go to my channel, there'll be times where I post a lot of videos, and there'll be times where the posting of new videos has really slowed down or maybe even seems to have stopped. Well, that is because at those times, I am closed captioning. I have a goal of not only making more calculus videos, like going into Calculus 2 and Calculus 3, but I also want to open up all of my videos so that, you know, deaf students, students who speak foreign languages as a primary language, or, you know, English as their second language, that might need those closed captions to go along with the lesson to help them understand them. And that takes a lot of time. A time I'm willing to give, but the more time I spend typing is the less time I get to record new math videos. And I do believe I'm going to focus for quite a while on getting a large number of my videos, much more of them, closed captioned. So far I have a little over 200 videos closed captioned, but I have at this point 580 math lessons. So I'm going to ask you guys for some help. If you would please do so, let me show you how to do this on your end. And any help I could get would be greatly, greatly appreciated. Thank you very much. Well, to start off, like I said, if I do not post videos for a while, if you've noticed it's been a few weeks or longer that I have not posted a new math video, you can go to my Facebook fan page and see that every time I create some closed captions and get that finished, that I post it up here. And you know, if my viewers also help me out, I give them some credit there as well. And you'll find the same thing on my Twitter page, where I say, hey, by the way, we've got more videos that are now closed caption, now over 200 closed caption videos that are also still free that you can use to help you learn math. And on your end, this is how you're going to want to do that. Now, let's see here. I want to log this in as myself, which is the YouTube channel that I don't have any videos on. If you would like to help, this is how you could do it. You could come to my channel, youtube.com, ProfRobBob, of course. You're here. You already know that. Go to videos. And anything with a CC in the top, in the bottom left-hand corner has already been closed captioned. You can look at these videos from the time at which I've uploaded them or going from the most popular backwards. I've been generally doing the most popular videos going backwards. Yes, one of my most popular videos is how to build a couch out of pallets. And I'm, you know, trying to get the most bang for my buck, if you will, and closed caption the videos that get watched the most. But find anything that does not have a CC next to the video, and that is going to need closed captions. So let's find here product to sum and product and sum to product formulas. If you click on this, and let's stop that ad. There we go. Now you'll notice there's not a CC mark in here because, well, closed captions are not done. So you can hit the settings button, go to subtitles. Click that you would like to help me out by adding subtitles, select language, English, and what you're going to notice here is actually somebody else has already been helping me, a student actually, it's not even my own student, has been helping me to close caption these videos. And there's already been some here, this is a video is partially done, so if these were your closed captions, you could up here say edit. This is the latest community version. Let's go ahead and skip to the end and start adding some more. Now, there are keyboard shortcuts here, like shift left is to skip back 5 seconds. You'll use that quite a bit. Shift to the right, which is forward 5 seconds. I don't know why anybody would want to do that. Shift space will pause your video, and you can add a new line as well. I'll show you how to do that. The video will pause as you stop typing, as you start to type, or you can tell the video when to pause. I do that with the shift space all the time, so I generally leave this unclicked. You can watch this video at full speed.
Clean things up a little bit.
Or you can watch it at half speed, which is going to be my personal choice. And let's just see how it goes here. So I'm going to hit shift space and start the video.
Let's get rid of the negative coefficient.
Now you can listen to a little bit of it like I just did and hit the shift space and pause it, or you can type a little bit while it goes, and then once it gets too far ahead, you can pause the video.
So we have those angles, and we're up a little bit.
I just did shift back arrow to get that.
So we have those angles, and we're going to...
Now I said, so we have in those angles, which doesn't make any sense. If you happen to notice that I say something that's kind of nonsensical, please feel free to make me sound smarter than I am.
Have in those angles, and we're going to do that. Through these ideas.
Now, you don't want this text to go more than two lines, so I'm going to go ahead and hit Enter or Plus. The return key on your keyboard will do this. And you see it just inserted that text box, basically, into the video.
Through these identities, through these problems. Remembering the, we're going to do that through these identities, through these problems. Remembering the even and odd properties of our different triggers.
Okay, now, depending on how well you type, of course, is going to determine the speed at which this process goes. I'm not the fastest typer, even though I've closed captioned over 200 videos now. I have, of course, gotten some help from a wonderful young lady, Jigyasa, in India, and some other random viewers, some of which I know and some of which I don't know, have helped me as well. Some of them doing, you know, multiple videos.
Now, this particular example is just in the sine. And the sine wave noise.
Okay, so basically goes to that, you know, something to that effect. That's pretty much it. Once you are done, whether it's the whole video, you can see this takes a long time. That's why I'm asking for some crowdsourcing help. Or you just want to do a couple of minutes. If this is all you want to do, then you go, hey, submit this for review. Now, this is new since the last time I made a request for help. You definitely, unless you're at the end of the video, please click no, let others keep working on it. If you click yes, they're ready to be reviewed, I get a notification that this video is done, and if I approve it, it shows up as if the video is completely closed captioned, even though it is only partially done. So if you are not at the end of the video, please click no, let others keep working on it. Now, this is new. I feel really bad because I got some really good quality closed captions when I asked for help the first time, and I had no idea who did the work. But now they have this wonderful little box that if you would like to be credited with helping to closed caption a video when it's all done, you know, and I would like to say thank you. So go ahead and click that box and hit submit. Now, if later on, and they'll suggest, they'll give you some suggestions on what you could do next. Later on, if you're just surfing around YouTube and you go, it's next day, it's, you know, whatever. Yeah, I watch a lot of car videos. you want to help me close caption some more videos, you just, you know, go to your channel or your creator studio. Nope, don't have any yet. That's absolutely correct. Go to community and contribute subtitles and CCs. If you were to just exit, by the way, and not submit for review, you would have a draft here. But you can go to My Contributions and go back to Product and Sum, Product to Sum and Sum to Product Formulas, and you'll see that your work is still in there. Or if anyone has added any closed captions since you had worked on a particular video, of course, their work will be in there as well. And now you'll notice here that it says Edit, as opposed to Submit Closed Captions or whatever it said before. There's no box up here to start typing. So you can hit edit and this opens back up again, and here's your box to continue to add more subtitles. You do not need to put anything in these boxes here unless, of course, you find something that's incorrect. You would go to the end. You can just click here to kind of let it jump ahead and start.
And the sine wave, knowing that it's it's passing through the origin, and if we take the sine function and we rotate it 180 degrees, we're going to have...
There. And that is it. Now, if you find this process too tedious and you would like to help, you could always submit. Well, let me get this out of the way. Nope, let other people work on it. Submit. Now, if you, I'm going to video manager like I've got videos. Now, if you want to play a video and just type, because you're just an amazing typist, you want to watch the video at 1/4 speed as opposed to half speed. Let me get this typed in here real quick. You can pick a video and, you know, just start playing it. This is basically how I, for the most part, close caption my videos. I get to see a different video than you do, but basically what I do is watch it at 1/4 speed, which is, you know, very difficult to listen to be honest, unless the sound quality is good. I'm not sure why there's no sound this time. Must be because I'm recording. But you can play it at a really slow rate and then just type into a Word document. Once you get that Word document, or in this case pages, typed up, this was for hyperbolic functions, you can email that to me at helpprofrobbobcc at gmail.com, and you could just email me a document, which then I can upload into the video and let YouTube auto, what's the word I'm looking for? Auto-time it to the video. So if you would be willing to give me any help, I would be really greatly appreciated. And of course, obviously, it would speed up my process for closed captioning. I'm Mr. True. Thank you so much for your help, if you can give.